Hey everybody, solo lesson for you with a short analysis of the solo. The idea is that you not only learn the solo, but also you can understand what's happening. I'm Everton Zakini, and today I'll show you the solo of the song Living in a Prayer by the band Bon Jovi. This solo lesson will be split in three parts. First, we're gonna see the solo slow, that you can learn note by note. Then I'm going to show you a short analysis of the solo, what's happening, the scales, the chord progression, the key of the song. And to finish, I will show you the solo in a normal speed, and you can follow with the tabs as well. So let's start with the solo slow. The song Living on a Prayer was released in 1986, and it's in the album Slippery When Wet by Bon Jovi. The guitar player who wrote this solo was Richie Sambora, which is also one of the composers of the song. The key of the song is E minor, and let's see what are the chords. Remember that every time that you're learning a solo, if you want to understand, it's really important that you understand the chord progression that's happening for you to know why the solo is sounding great. Every time that you have a great solo, you have a pretty good rhythm part behind. So it's really important to understand it. So let's take a look at the chords. On the chord progression, basically we have the chords E minor, C, G, and D. So all chords from the E minor. So that's the chord progression. Now that you know the chords, let's take a look at the scales that was used. Very easy on this part. Basically, we have most time E minor scale. You can think the E minor as a relative of G major. So basically, E minor, G major scale was used in the solo. Just one part that you have the E minor blues scale just at the beginning and at the end with some chromatism. It will be very easy for you to identify the scales. Now, on this solo, I want to talk a little bit more about the melodic lines, especially because Rich Sambora is pretty good creating melodic lines for the guitar. He has a great feeling. And this is the influence I got from Rich Sambora to create melodic, beautiful lines. This melodic line, these feelings, is not only about to play long notes or play slow. Sometimes you can play fast or more notes and create beautiful melodies. So Rich Sambora creates so many beautiful melodic lines on the guitar. Other example of guitar players, you can see Andy Timmons or Eric Johnson, that they will be playing some lines fast, but sounds beautiful. There are context and feeling inside of a fast phrase. And for this solo, what I think of this solo is really nice is that you can sing very easily the solo. So that's the point when you have some beautiful and melodic lines on your solo, that people can hear it and can sing the melodies. This makes a lot of difference on your guitar solos. So if you want to start to compose your solos and improvise, try to find melodic lines. Remember, it can be fast or slow, but lines that people can sing easily. Lines that will be easy to understand. It doesn't need to be easy to play, but easy to understand, and that sounds beautiful. So let's get some parts of the solo to understand these melodic lines and also to understand the context with the chords. That's something that is really nice on this solo. The first part, we have this melody. So basically these lines, if you take a look at the solo with the chords, you see that most times the notes of the solo will be following the chords. I don't think that Rich Sambora chose the notes, just think about the chords. I think it was naturally, he just feel, he was listening to the chords, and by ear he could get and create the melody and get all the notes spot on. So the first part we have the minor chord, right over the D. So this D here is right over the D chord. Second part here, this note C, you'll be over the C chord. On the second part we have this melody, G note over the G, the C note over the C, and then we have a bend reaching E and D. So notice how the melody will be matching with the chords. Second part over the E minor and C chord, and then we have the D and this phrase on D. Like a small arpeggio here of D. D with the fourth. So I have here the fourth of D, the F sharp, the major third, then the root D, and then the fifth, A. Then over the D, then we have the same motif here over the G and C chords. And just to finish it differently, and fret phrase here. So this phrase, pentatonic, with chromatism. So notice how these melodic lines will be related to the chords. Usually the best notes when you play is the notes from the chords. So it's gonna sound really good. Another thing that I wanna point out in this solo is the first phrase. This is something very characteristic of Rich Sambora. You'll find in so many of his solos this idea here. This is on a minor pentatonic with the bend. So you find it on other songs as well. So the idea is that you can get some notes, some motifs, and you twist it, and then you can have in a different way. For example, this is for Living on a Prayer. If you get another song, Money, Dead or Alive, the idea on this solo is very similar to what he used on Living on a Prayer. So it's something like that. Another song, Bed of Roses, same idea. Very similar ideas that was used in different songs, so that's something that you can use. You can learn this idea and use it your own way. That's what we call stealing phrases. And it makes part for our development as a musician to steal these phrases from other guitar players and apply in our own style. So I can use this. So instead of using it this way. I can do it several different ways. The idea is that you can use this kind of notes and change the way that you play them, that you can have new melodies. And if you analyze and learn the songs that the guitar players that you like, and you find so many characteristics, things in common that they use. Now I'm going to play the solo in a normal speed, and you can follow with the tabs as well. If you like this video, remember to hit the like. This way you'll be helping me to keep creating content. If you like these lessons, I have more solo lessons here and lessons about other things. If you want to support this channel, remember to subscribe and ring the bell so you don't miss the lessons that I'm posting every week. Thanks for watching. See you next time.